Greetings and salutations once again, everyone. Huh? This is new. Seto, Yugi called me, he said that the thief escaped. I knew he'd fail. Previous to God of Times my tournament. I'm gonna use all of my Capricorn resources to find a crook, no matter where he's hiding. He'll regret ever taking me on. I'm coming in. Huh? President of Capricorn. You probably come with to be in his cup. Yes. By the door, the thief escaped. I'm sure you're no happy camper. That's why I'll give you Capricorn's newest innovation, upgrade parts for your dual disc. Use it to find a punk for your own hands. These upgrades detect powerful duelists and push you in their direction. I also give these parts to other duelists so we can trap the thief in no time. I have no doubt that the criminal is a duelist, but only a high level duelist could pull off such a crime. Find him and beat him in a duel. Maybe then you'll get your pride back. Well, that's kind of handy, but in the previous episode we found Bandit Keith, dueled him, and we didn't get our prize back. So this episode we're actually supposed to look for fame. We're supposed to look for the thief, whoever that is, because it may not even be Bandit Keith. And you can tell now that the stars there with Yugi. It will show how powerful they are during that day, so this will show that Yugi uses like his tournament deck. And it shows this is a one-star duelist, such as Taya. Which I'm gonna duel her. Can everybody give me the upgrade pass? Here's a hot after all. Let's duel. I have to waste my level by fighting tough opponents. Sure. I could go to a card shop, but I will after this duel. Now this is still a magic stage, so obviously I'm just going to basically just speed up this duel and then I'll buy the packs in the shop. This is a very good hand, I like this. No, how? What? Okay, that's weird. Activate Thunder Dragon's effect. Do that. Set that. And obviously, Giant Germ can just flip someone because it has the same attack as a skill hero. You guys can probably guess what's gonna happen. Do that. Boom. And end my turn with that. Flip over this Galengo. Set that and play swords and see what her face down is. Which now that we know, we can just win a duel. Actually, we won't win a duel this turn. She gets one more turn. Boom, boom, and boom. Could play Deck Destruction Best, which I'm going to. It could be Giant German, see what she has. Before anyways, I just attack with Fame, with Dark Elf, although for some reason I ended my turn, like a fool. Let's just do that, battle phase. At this point, duels will start getting new decks and stuff like that, which is quite handy. This is Pedigree. Flip summon. I'll get swords back to the hand, because it doesn't matter what I bring back anyways. He's gonna lose. I could have used Pedigree to maybe get polymerization, but eh. In this case, now I do draw a pot, like, I use Pedigree and adore polarization and blackluster ritual. In which case, I could use Giant Germ, Magician of Faith, and Fame. Yeah, level up. Maybe there'll be a new pack. That's so close to none of them, let's do it again next time. And that's it for the shop then. And obviously just speed up, because I'm buying packs anyways. We don't even have a new pack. So, first of all, I'll try and finish up the Grand Illusions pack. Was that it? It was, we were just missing Magician of Black Chaos. Brilliant. It's a powerful card. Diffusion, that's a good card. Take the fusion monster, sends it back to the deck, and the player plays the monsters that we use to fuse it. So if I wanted to, I could add it to the deck, play Twin Earth on Dragon Attack, then use Diffusion, and I get two more monsters to attack with. Or you could use it for defense as well, which is quite handy. Troubadour, that's a cool card. I like that. Gives you life points when you're summoned, but when it's destroyed by battle, you lose life points. Lose more in your game. Noxious Celtic Guardian. No. Right, back for Cursed Darkness. Once you do collect at least 50 of the cards in a pack, you get a thing from Solomon Moto. Basically, it's a deck recipe based on cards from that pack. Like, we get enough cards from here. Oh, these are some good cards. Bear the Magnum Warrior. Basically, three parts of them, combine them into Valkyrian, which we got as well. The Giant Grenade as well. That is brilliant. Axe of Despair, that's like pretty much my favorite equipped card. Blue Eyes Toon Dragon, that's awesome. I like that. And there's Alpha. If you get Alpha Beta Gamma, you can play Valkyrian. Which I can be a fun deck to make. Choose on the Skull again, pretty cool. Axe of Despair again, brilliant. First of all, I want to get Giant Grenade into the deck because that's brilliant. In fact, why to go all the way there is G. Because all spell and trap cards goes straight back to the hand. So even if you put it in something great, I can just get rid of the cards like that. In fact, I'm going to remove the two black pennies because I'm going to get Axe of Despair because I like that card, it's brilliant. Basically, it's two black pennies combined into one. It gives your monster 1,000 attack points, and instead of doing damage when it's destroyed, it lets you tribute the monster to get it back to your hand, which is great. Now, I believe... No, we can't access another area. That's a shame. There's Yugi, which we don't need to duel him. There's a 1-star door, so it's Serenity, Wax, or Faint here. Maybe he has a new deck, though it's 1-star, so it's still Dire Destructions, so just do them. Let's see how the new revision of the deck goes. Pretty good, I say. Oh, he's fusing. This dinosaur, yes. Not a good situation to be in, that's for sure. Well, it would be a good situation if I didn't have Hornet Unicorn. I did go through a lot of work to play that monster, but I did less work to destroy it. Stem pack, okay. There's 23 to 25, there was really no point in doing that. Fowler. If it was Julia, I'd be worried because he'd have skull dice or something, but all he did was take less damage. Could have summoned Dark Elf and attack. I could have played Numinous. Oh, negate attack. That's brilliant. But this will allow me to play Numinous anyways. He does get to play a monster. Up summon, I'll play Source to see what his fate down is. It's Gear Source. Which I know how Gear Source is a monster. Like it's just weak. Let's see, he does nothing. Well, he couldn't anyways. There's Blacklist of Soldier. And there are certain combinations you could do to play Blacklist of Soldier easily. If you can send it to the grave and use a card called Call of the Haunted or Monster Reborn, you could just bring it back without having a ritual summon it. And that will probably be a strategy I use later on. I was taking it easy on you. No, you weren't taking it easy. You were just weak. No excuses. There's a one star being tear, so I'll do it. And I'll go first. Ooh, this is a good hand to start off with. Graceful Charity. And to ease. Like that. And then my turn. Oh, this is good. I like it. Pretty handy. You just read your effect. This goes directly from your deck to the graveyard by an effect of a card. I think that's one actually. Play Graceful Charity back to the hand. And of course I'm going to play Graceful Charity. Got three, and I'll discard these two. And I can't play Blackluster Ritual, which is a big sad. Very big sad. Now I could destroy her penguin. Like a penguin soldier. That sounds way too wild. Why does it sound wild to me? It shouldn't. Looks like Manny a bug. Destroy that. I'm just waiting to get Blacklist Soldier on the field. I could use Horned Unicorn to Axe of Despair. And just start doing some damage, but I don't see a reason to. He has 12,200 life points, which is quite handy. But look, that's 4,700. Just put it by itself, and here's something else I'll do. Just do huge damage. 4,250. You can't even argue with that. It's brilliant. Like, if I can get a powerful enough monster, I can just take away a third of a life points every turn. So you get a free Solemn Wishes and you won't be able to do anything. That doesn't do anything for you, Teo. In fact, that actually helps me. Because what I can do is equip that to Manny a bug. I know it was Gold 7, but still. If it was something that had decent defense, it would have just made it so she would lose regardless. Like, all she did was power up my monster. If she draws the D spell and gets her Horned Unicorn, I draw it again next turn. If it's actually a spell, I'll just tribute Magician of Faith. This way, drop 4,000. Or not. Because she's just being cheap now. You've already lost. There's nothing you can do. Yeah, the position of face. There's 300, so I'll need to attack with Giant Gem anyways. And the Black Lesser Soldier will finish you off. Brilliant. You know, it's not gonna be anything, will you? This depends, Pikachu has to still stack up. Yes, that way I don't have to duel you again. Because now I know where it should be. So this is all. This obviously isn't Tear. This is like Rex Raptor or Serenity. And now we know she's up there. And that's another duel, it's like Serenity. Now I do think he actually needed to be nighttime. There's a lot of one-star duelists. Heck. Yeah, let's just go for this one. Because I think you have to. I think it needs to be nighttime anyways. And just go walk. Start off with Thunder Dragon, obviously. I haven't eaten anything today, and hunger is hitting me, so I'll probably guess for eat after this episode. Boom. You will do damage, but that's fine. The triple giant gem. Start off a giant today, get rid of his spells. Or traps, whichever they are. I'm keeping Thunder Dragon ready just in case I need it. You could say I could have just discarded Tributary Doom, and that's true. But with Negate Attack, I can just stop his attack next turn, whatever it is, and destroy his monster. And if I draw a train head, if I draw a polymerization, then even better. Like, I didn't draw it, but still. I can get rid of Thunder Dragon. That's a good angle. And just attack him directly. In fact, I think that's actually a victory. Yeah, it is. Because any of folks could do barely enough. I think next episode from now on, I may just start making a different deck and playing like so many duels with it. Because I think this deck is near perfect. Yeah, there probably are better duels than the Expert Cup. Two star duels, which is Mako. Very well, might as well fight him. Pretty good situation there, Simon. Oh, but he's going for a ritual summon. And he actually brought out the ritual monster. Activating the gate attack. Yeah, we seem to destroy managers. I don't want having multiple monsters on the field. Simple as that. Yeah, could have attacked a Crash Clown, but to me, this is a better strategy. Where's the duck? Switch to defense mode. Made a huge error in your mistake there. A huge error in your strategy. A huge error in your mistake, wouldn't it? I know how to speak proper. Switch to attack mode, switch to attack mode, and I get to draw a free card, which I'll set, because it's another skill angle. But yeah, he should have attacked Glass Clown first, since he could have destroyed it. Padilla always attacks the monsters in the far left zone. Let's see, you're 1800. So what I'll do is just that. Oh, actually no. Because he's attacking skill angle, I'd rather draw the card. Polymerization, pretty handy. And nope, I don't need to do that. Yeah, I was thinking of using Deck Destruction Virus, but I don't need to now. Because the fight is already over. Can you attack? I'll set that. Enter the battle phase. Two giant germs. And you could think that's a mistake, but this is what I'm doing. Pretty much just an advanced play, because why not? Let's see, there's a dupe over here, 2-star, probably Mako. We can't find who we're looking for now, Dolan. Well, I'm not looking for anyone specific, obviously I'm looking to continue the story, but I think it has to be during night for that. Wow, hunger has really hurt me, like a fight train. Gonna do this person, it's Piccola. So let's see how we do this. Let's just minute attack. Should we summon? And there's some huge damage for you. William. Summon and equip Horn to Unicorn onto Luminous Knight. Main reason being that Dementia Warrior is just going to get banished the second destroys a monster, so I'm best off just attacking with Luminous. I'll continue the attack. I take under a 50, but your monster's banished now. It was a waste of a card. I call it Haunted. Like, it was an absolute waste. And end my turn. It just goes back to the top of the deck. Like, you really aren't doing anything. But I will just keep it that way. Nope. If I can get Mystical Space, that'd be great. Wow, you didn't get anything with that. And fight. Yeah, because it's not in a good situation. In fact, I'm going to do the second main phase. I'm just going to play Hornet the Unicorn again. Reason being, if he is going to destroy any of the cards, he'll want to destroy Haunted Unicorn. No, go back to top of deck, so he'll just be in a bad situation. So we'll be doing what's known as a deck out, where if you have no cards to draw at the start of your turn, you lose. Simple as that. And there's the underdog. Every time he draws a yellow card or a monster, he'll get to draw again, which is quite fun. You can just make a really mean deck with it, where you keep drawing yellow cards so you get Exodia. And you can have one specific card to get the effect version of Exodia. Free star duelist is Solomon. Find out earlier. I'll go first. It's only a 30 minute episode, jeez! Have a pot of greed, draw two. In graceful charity. Oh, this is very mean. I don't like it. This way, graceful charity is good. You get so many good and bad options. Let me go with these two. I just summon gear source and defense. Set that and end my turn. And after this duel, I end the episode and get something to eat because I'm starving. Poison the old man, pretty good card. Flip summon, draw more. Switch to attack, summon, and set. Now a cool combination you could do is use Giant Tornado with Cold Wave. Actually you couldn't, because you had to play Cold Wave as the first card during the turn. I think that there could have been some sort of strategy you could use, where you play Giant Tornado and then make it say he gave his sack cards next turn with Cold Wave, but you can't. Because you had to play Cold Wave first, then you wouldn't even be able to play Giant Tornado at that point. It'd just be a waste. Cold Wave is a very good first turn card though, because then no one can do anything. Like, all you can do is summon monsters. And victory. Brilliant. That was a bit too short of a duel. I'll see if we can advance the story. I think we're looking for a 4-star duelist. Or a 5-star, let's see. Oh, it's Yami Yugi. Anything new about those creeps? Okay, let me test the trick to your deck, just in case you want to turn. Yes, this is Yugi using his most powerful deck, Union Force. This is all about the card Valkyrian the Magnan Warrior, which we got earlier, I believe, during this episode. Which in this episode or last episode. But it's all about so many monsters like that. And basically having high power. And since it's a new deck, I will just show the duel in full. Even if this episode takes 40 minutes. Rock Bombardment. He can just discard cards and do damage to me, but he got rid of his ace card in the deck for some reason. Although I will use Fruit upon the Dragon's Effect because the animation is slow. There's probably a way to stop that, but still. The polarization. Boom! Yeah, we're in a good position. The only scary card he has is Mirror Force. He probably has a face down, but so what? Oh, Magical Art, never mind. Mystic Box and Mirror Force. He got with the Mirror Force, you fool! He got rid of his best card. Yeah, I'm not telling you yet, breaking a Magical Warrior will just destroy a spell. Or not! Thanks for that, I guess. You just take 500 damage for free. And all you have to do is play Dark Destruction Bias, and most of his monsters are just gonna die. So you can't even play Valkyrian now. He can only play monsters with 1400 or less attack. Yeah, he's lost. It may be a 5-star duelist, but it's not much he can do. Oh, he's drawn Snatch still. Oh, you jerk. Now I'm not getting any attack. I get 1000 life points each turn, which is quite cool. Hold on, I'm just gonna destroy Twin Heaven and Dragon. I don't want to be controlled by anyone but me. It's pretty much my ace card. Boom. And end my turn with that. Oh, we can't play anything, can we? That's a shame. I'm just kidding. It's super funny. It's like the most powerful duelist in the game, and I'm shredding it. Die. Beautiful. Restore and bottom your cards. There's a 3-star duelist. Oh, it's Bandicoot. Oh, hi Yugi. I see the strong signal in this area. You'll just start going bonkers around here so you can check it out. Just saw somebody over there. That's where the signal's coming from. Sense something dangerous. We meet again. Enough of your games, Keith. Give me back the cards you stole. She's you again. You're like a bad watch. It won't go away. I'll finish you for good to time. Stop. Don't be so hasty, Bandicoot. Sorry, sir. Let me handle this. You're Pegasus. Pleased to meet you, beginner champion. I've tracked you made it this far. Since you've made it to this tournament, I have a special prize just for you. I'll tell you personally. It's not every day to create a duel once challenges an aperture to a duel. You should be honored. If you win, though the odds are tiny, I'll give you back the grand prize Bandicoot stole. But it's mine. It's mine! You fool. Are you seeing that I'm going to lose? No, sir, I'm sorry. So I will do this duel in the next episode. So I'll see you guys then.